Hi everyone, my name's Megan, welcome to my channel. Today I'm going to talk about my minimalist baby essentials. This is my daughter Sophia, she'll be joining us today. Are you going to be good? Maybe. We'll see. You're too cute.
Bye.
So today I wanted to talk a little bit about what things you actually need for a baby. I'm about to be a second time mom. I am 20 weeks pregnant with our second little bundle of joy. And I learned so much with what you actually need for a baby with Sophia. There are so many baby products out there, and there are constantly companies who sell these products trying to tell you how awesome they are and how you absolutely need every one of them, and that's just not true. You actually don't need all that much for a baby, and so I'm going to share with you my list of things that you actually do need, and hopefully it's helpful. So let's get right into this list. So I've kind of divided up all these products by sections, and the first section is clothing / diapering. So the first thing is onesies. I pretty much only dress my baby in onesies. I do not like all these fancy baby outfits. They're totally unnecessary. I know that all the little shoes and accessories and outfits are just super cute and really hard to resist buying, but it's kind of hard to dress a baby in these things, and babies spit up and they have blowouts, and I'm not gonna put my baby in a fancy every time they have a blowout. So I love just some plain gender neutral onesies. I like to have some short sleeve and some long sleeve onesies because I've ended up having both my babies either in the winter or the early spring, and we live in Montana and it's pretty cold here. I really like the Burt's Bees organic cotton for both onesies and sleepers, and that's the next thing on my list is sleepers. Footed sleepers. I like to have some of the fleecy ones and some of just the plain organic cotton ones. Just for on those chilly nights when you need a little bit of extra something to put your baby in a fleecy sleeper, they're really nice.
Hello.
I prefer the zipper ones just because they're really fast to get on and off at night when you're trying to change diapers, but the button ones are really good too. I've used both kinds. You actually probably don't need to put any clothes on your baby registry because that's the first thing that people buy you when you have a baby shower is clothes. We are gonna be dressing Sophia in clothes that we got from her baby shower until she's two. And then the next thing on the list for me is cloth diapers. We have cloth diapered her since she was a newborn. I love cloth diapers. I love that I don't have to go to the store and buy disposables. I love that they're healthy on her skin. And cloth diapering really isn't as hard as a lot of people think it is. My favorite cloth diapers are actually pocket diapers. As my babies get older, pocket diapers don't work quite as well for absorbency at night, just because my daughter's a heavy wetter, so I like using diaper covers with several different inserts. But for the first at least 8 months, pocket diapers are my go-to method. For inserts, my favorite are the pre-folds. They're just really easy and simple and very absorbent. And then I also love that when you're done cloth diapering, you can just use those as rags because they're big rectangles. They're not just the little pads. So not only are they my favorite cloth diapers, but they're also multi-use for after you're done cloth diapering. I like just cotton pre-folds are my favorite. I'll link some down below that we use. I also really like to use hemp inserts. The Thirsties brand are my favorite. I will link those down below as well. And then for wipes, we just use some small, soft baby washcloths. We bought like 3 packs of these washcloths, and I only use them for wipes, and they work really great. I don't have to constantly be buying wipes from the store. I plan on cloth diapering this next baby, even though Sophia and next one will only be 15 months apart. So I will have two in diapers at once for a while, but I still totally plan on cloth diapering because I love it so much. And once you get the hang of it especially, it's really, really easy. Now let's move on to bedding and blankets. Now this next thing is one of my absolute favorite baby products ever, and that is muslin swaddle blankets. I use these for literally everything. Obviously, I use them for swaddling. They're my favorite swaddles. I don't think it's really that necessary to buy sleep sacks and those swaddles that zip up and have Velcro and all these fancy things. Some moms swear by them, so you may end up liking these, but I find they're totally unnecessary and they're really expensive, and you also have to buy them in several different sizes. The muslin swaddle blankets all come in one size. They're just one big square of muslin and you wrap it around your baby. And there's different ways that you can swaddle them as they get bigger and stronger to keep them from breaking out. I also use these muslin swaddle blankets for burp rags. I use them for nursing covers. I tie 2 corners around the back of my neck and use it as a nursing cover. So that makes it so that having an extra nursing cover that's only has the one use, I don't need to have one of those. I don't need to have a whole ton of burp rags. I really love things that are multi-use, multifunctional. I have about 15 to 20 swaddle blankets. I know that my daughter's 10 months old. I don't use them anymore, but I'm definitely going to be using them with the next baby. Then my next thing is a heavier blanket, especially if your baby's born in the winter or the early spring or if it's going to be cold. I love having another heavy blanket to use in the car or if it's just chilly in the living room and I have them wrapped in their muslin blankets. And then I also wrap another heavier blanket around them just for snuggling. I don't let them use it by themselves if they're taking a nap by themselves, but heavier blanket has super come into handy with Sophia. And the next thing is crib sheets. I really love the Burt's Bees organic cotton crib sheets. They're just super high quality and I love that they're healthy on my baby's skin. My baby won't probably be using crib sheets until they're probably about 6 months old or more because we bed share for the first few months and then after that they sleep in a bassinet next to our bed. And then once they're 6 months old and I'm like, okay, I need you to be in your own space just for my own sanity, then is when we will transition them to the crib. So Sophia wasn't sleeping in her crib until she was like 6 or more months old. But after they are, I like to have several different sets of crib sheets in case they leak in their diaper or spit up or something like that. It's nice to have several different sets. Now let's move on to more of year type stuff. The first thing in that section is actually a baby wrap or some sort of baby carrier. When Sophia was little, I loved the baby wraps. It's just basically a really long piece of fabric that's stretchy and you wrap it around your body. I actually have a tutorial on how to do this. It's a little bit confusing at first, but once you get the hang of it, it's really simple. And then your baby can just sit right close to your body and snuggle you, and you can still go around the house and get stuff done. I am guessing that I will use it even more with this next baby than I did with Sophia because I'll have to be walking around taking care of Sophia still. As Sophia got older, I preferred the backpack carrier a little bit more just because she was more wiggly and she had more room to move in that one. The next thing is a sound machine. Now this is a lifesaver. Sound machines are so handy and I even like having one in our room now that I've gotten used to it. It just drowns out all those little household noise that might wake your baby up if they're sleeping on their own. We love having a sound machine in Sophia's room, and it's also handy to have a portable one if you are going to be traveling and you want to take it in the car and have your baby sleep for a long time. So definitely a sound machine is a must for us. We really loved having a bassinet after about the first 3 months. As I said, before that we bed shared, so she just slept right with us. And then after that, I wanted a little bit more of my own space so I could sleep a little bit deeper. And so then we got one of those rock and play bassinets and set it right next to my bed so I could just reach over, grab her, nurse her, put her right back. And so I didn't even have to get out of bed. I didn't even have to sit up. And so those were just really, really nice for when your baby's still nursing a lot during the night and you want them still really close, but not just right with you. And then after about 6 months, we moved her into a crib, and that has been really nice. She sleeps in her own room now. She sleeps in her crib. And so that is another essential for us. And then another thing that we didn't use until after about 6 months is a high chair. We have one that actually clips onto our table so she can eat right with us, right with the entire family, which is really handy. I might not start this next baby on solids until they're even a little bit older. One of the main reasons I started my daughter on solids at 6 months was because I got pregnant with this one, and so she wasn't getting quite as much breast milk. But high chairs are really handy because you don't want to be chasing your baby around trying to feed them food all the time. Then obviously you will need a car seat. We have just a simple Graco car seat that clicks into a base that's installed in the car. It's just really handy to have that base installed in the car that I use the most often, so it's just really fast to take the car seat in and out. We got one that's actually a set that came with the car seat and the stroller, which is super handy. I love having that stroller. We go on a lot of walks, and I love that when they're little, the car seat just clips right into the stroller. And then when they get older and they don't want to be in the car seat, there's another place for them to sit up. And the next thing is a diaper bag. I've been using one for Sophia that's a little bit smaller, and it's worked great for just having one baby, but I'm definitely going to need to get a bigger one when I have two, and they're both going to be in diapers for a while. I really love the backpack style ones. They are a lot easier to carry around. They can hold a lot. So definitely a high quality diaper bag that's not going to start falling apart after a few months of use. And now let's move on to the feeding category. And I actually only have a couple things in this category because since I breastfeed my babies, you don't need a whole lot to do that. The first thing on the list are breast pads. I'm one of those women who leak a lot, especially at the beginning. I think most women do. So I have reusable breast pads that I can just throw in the washer when they get soaked up with milk, and then I don't have to be constantly leaking through my clothes, and it's just really nice. After the first few months, I don't need them anymore. This is another use for those pre-fold cloth diapers is I would have a stack of those next to my bed at night, and I could just use those diapers to soak up breast milk that was leaking. I prefer to use the breast pads in the day and then use more of a cloth type thing at night, but that's just to get another use for those pre-fold cloth diapers. Even if you're not cloth diapering, they're just really handy to have. The next thing is a haka, and that is a little silicone breast pump, and it's actually meant to catch the letdown on the other side. So your baby's nursing, say, on the right side, both sides will let down, and a lot of milk will go to waste on the other side, unless you're catching it with something. So I found the haka to be super handy. You can actually manually pump with it, even if your baby's not getting it to let down. If you're really engorged in the beginning, you can manually pump to just relieve some of that engorgement and to get a nice freezer stash without having to actually use an electric pump. Now let's move on to the last category, which is bathing. Now when my babies are newborns, I don't bathe them. I especially wait until the umbilical cord stump has fallen off because you don't want to get that wet. You want it to dry out. But then even after that, babies really don't get all that dirty unless they've had a blowout or spit up all over themselves. So I would just use a cloth and get it wet with warm water and use some Castile soap and just give them a sponge bath. Once you do start bathing them, you don't really need one of those fancy baby bathtubs. They're just kind of unnecessary and take up a lot of space, and your baby grows out of them really fast. What we'll probably do with this next baby is just fold up a big towel and lay it in the bottom of the tub, and then fill up the tub just a couple inches, and then you can lay the baby on the towel, and that works really well. And then for soap, all I've ever used on my daughter is Dr. Bronner's Castile soap. It's really healthy on their skin. I do not like using any of the Johnson's soap or any of the conventional baby soaps. They're just full of toxins and bad stuff, and your baby's skin just soaks all that up. So I love using Castile soap on my babies, and maybe adding a little bit of essential oils and diluting it with water. But for washcloths, we just use our own washcloths. I don't buy any special ones for them. And that is actually it. You don't need a ton of stuff. This is a pretty minimalist list, but it can be really confusing for first-time parents who are trying to figure out what to put on their baby registry, and there's just so many products out there. And so these are the things that I feel that you actually need. Now obviously there's more things that you can use that come in handy maybe, but are just sort of extras that aren't like really essentials. So I hope this video was helpful or entertaining. Thank you for watching, and I will see you in my next video. Bye.